जाने Our first eminent speaker of the day is respected by the M Gopikrishna sir. Sir is the professor and HOD at Rasa Shastra department at SJG Ayurveda Medical College. Sir is an Ayurvedic Vaidya with Rasa Shastra specialty. He was associated with various projects and experiences in SDM pharmacy for 3 years during post-graduation. He is a successful clinical as well as academic person with a multidimensional views regarding theory and practical approaches of Ayurvedic science, especially in Rasa Shastra. Sir is experienced in Marma Chikitsa and practices it in day-to-day clinical practice in various disorders. He has worked for standardization of Ayurvedic preparations in Department of Microscopic Metallographic Technique to find the changes in various metals during Shodhan and Maran, analyzing various qualitative and quantitative methods with atomic absorption spectrophotometry, X-ray diffraction technique. He has conducted field survey at Kerala State at Trivandrum area and witnessed the art of Marma Chikitsa. He has conducted drug surveys at Maravatu Malai Forest area, Kanyakumari Forest area, and has collected a huge number of various samples of Rasa Shastra, nearly more than 600 samples as a personal museum. He also has a collection of rare rasa aushadhis like Agnisthai Hingul, Agnisthai Gauri Pashan, etc. I would now like to request sir to please start his session. Everyone please put their phones on silent mode.
Good morning to everyone. Say a warm welcome on the day two of the session. And I'll be starting with a few of my ideas about the topic, the Pottali Kalpanas in the Rasa Shastra, a clinical orientation, perceptive, also a brief about the method of preparations. Salutation to the God. Without His grace, nothing is possible in Ayurveda, especially in Rasa Shastra. Added to this, I like to acknowledge my sincere thanks to the whole group of Nanal Foundation of Research for inviting me over here and permitting me to have a few of my ideas to be shared with you people. So these are the Pottali Kalpanas, possibly most of you would be knowing. As a part of introduction, let me run through the slides just to see that we'll cover with the time. Rasa Shastra is primarily made up of four Rasayana Kalpas. The first one is the Karaliya Rasayana, Parpati Kalpanas, Kupi Pakva, and Pottali. Pottali is considered one of the most potent medicine, the reasons which we'll be trying to elicit in another 1 hour of presentation. So this is the definition which we get right from the textbook for the Pottali Kalpanas. Main theme is the condensation, the process by which the drugs are being totally been molecularized in a drug design. It's called as a biological drug designing. And the references on the textual aspect, I'll not be going in detail, just to cover up with the time. The history, of course, we don't have the references from the Samhitas, either from the Brahatrehi or Laghutrehi. Later part of Laghutrehi, you have lots of references regarding the Pottali Kalpanas. And among them, you can see, if you can enumerate from the textbook, there are approximately around 70 Pottali Kalpanas which are explained in the text. Out of that, 40 are prime, just because of the reason many Pottali Kalpanas are similar with a different name or slight alterations in the compositions. But anyway, the evolution will not stop. We have to continue the evolution. So on that grounds, the way what I have contributed to the science of the Pottali Kalpanas will be shared for a few more time of one hour. Say, for example, the necessity of the Pottali Kalpanas, why we need it, because many of them are not very much familiar in using the Pottali Kalpanas. Why we need it? There are primarily two reasons why we need these Kalpanas. One thing is the convenience. You need not carry them in bulk. One small tablet is enough to possibly cure around 100 people. So the quantity or the dosage or the form taken is very, very, very minimum. It is the convenience. The second thing is the enhancement of the properties. So both of these things can be elicited in the further presentation. Enhancement of the property, yes, primarily it is because of the Gandhaka, which has been extensively used in preparation aspect of these Kalpanas. So everything you prepare in a pharmacy, it's directly related to the patient. Say, for example, you're not a pharmacist, you're a clinician. Think about this before you manufacture anything. Whatever you do, the forum or the presentation is absolutely not the prime criteria. The prime criteria is whether it cures my patient or not, whether it treats a particular condition or not. In case if it is not treating, then it's of no use. If it is treating, in whatever the form it is said to be the best variety of medicine. So this is the importance of sulfur, why we have in most of the Pottali Kalpanas. You take the medicine and it is boiled in the sulfur bath. This is a method of preparation. The whole of the medicine is being prepared and it is being heated in a sulfur bath for a set period of time. And during this process, four events will happen very commonly. One thing is the toxic effect of the mercury or any substance whichever used is being neutralized by Gandhak. Second thing is it fixes the mercury. It doesn't allow it to go out. See, for example, the Pottali is hanging inside the sulfur bath. It doesn't allow the mercury to go outside. It needs to stay within the aspect so that the end product is more potent and takes the maximum benefits of the mercury which is present in it. Therapeutically efficacious. All the elements here, it goes on with the anaerobic reactions because oxygen is not present in the reaction. It is totally anaerobic and it is therapeutically active. The most important part which we'll be dealing today, primarily it is the emergency medicine. Yes, Pottali Kalpanas are most of the times of the emergency medicines. You need to advise them or give it to the patient in all status. For me in my clinic, most of my practice is with Pottali Kalpanas. If the patient comes with a pratishaya or is a case of malignancy, my first thought is a Pottali Kalpana. Then I'll think of some other drugs as supportive medicines. So on this grounds, we can gross up convenient of the transportation, administration, dose fixation, preservation of the properties and emergency medicine. So this is a method of preparation. The said drug, whichever you want to prepare, is being triturated and it is made in the form of a bolus and it is kept in between the sulfur, shodhita, gandhaka, and a cloth and it is being tied. It is a silk cloth to be used here. And the gandhaka is taken in a valukayantra. It is melted and it is immersed in the form of dola yantra. And once it has been immersed, pakalakshanas are said in the text. According to that, it is to be collected later. You can see how it has been removed. The viscosity of gandhak is high later and it has been removed. This is a method of preparation unique for most of the Pottali Kalpanas. This is Vishagarbha Pottali, as an example I have shown it. So this is the method of preparation of most of the Pottalis. So these are the events which happens during the process of a Pottali Kalpana. And the first one is the ingredient. Almost in all the Pottali Kalpanas, Swarna and Parada are the essential components. Of course, the sulfur is there. In case if you add Tamra, it becomes Tamragarbha Pottali. You add Loha, it becomes Lohagarbha Pottali. You add Visha like Gauri Pashana, Haratala Manashila, it becomes Vishagarbha Pottali. So on that grounds, there are lots of variations in the textbook. So based on the preparation, Swarna and Parada are used. And among this, Swarna which is to be used is definitely because it is Atyanta Rasayana and also it is Agroshadi in treating Rakshogna. Sushruta included this Swarna as a Rakshogna Gana. So it is well protective to the patients very well. And Parada, Ashtasamskarita Parada is to be used. We don't use the Samanya or Vishesha Shodhana alone. After Samanya and Vishesha, Ashtasamskaras of the Parada is carried out and then we perform this preparation. Next thing is a binding agent. That is a most common time we take is aloe vera is taken for the bhavana. Kumari is taken. Of course, the text speaks about even the other substances like the babula, arka, everything. But depending on the conditions, definitely it can be altered. But for most of the preparations, it is aloe vera. The shape of the pottalis, the text speaks of various shapes. There are certain patients who take pottalis with me for years together. Say, for example, a diabetic patient. He takes a pottali which is having a size of nearly 300 to 500 grams. A person who wants to take it for 1 or 2 weeks, he takes a pottali size of 1 or 2 grams. So the shape and the quantity of each pottali varies based on these grounds. Either it is a shankakara, vatiyakara, shikarakara, or golakara, or the terms mentioned in the text. The vessels used, usually the earthen pots or the enamel pots are used, and silk cloth is used. Why silk cloth is used? The threading nature what you have in this, it's very, very fine and near, and it is heat resistant for the indirect heat. On that grounds, it is being taken. Of course, when the pottali kalpana came into existence, silk was used by the kings, and pottalis were used for treating the kings. So always a silk cloth came into existence, and India was a highest production of silk cloths in the world. On this grounds, as a royal element, even silk had it, the benefit of rasayana property because it has traces of gold. And quantity of sulfur, various textbooks speaks of various quantities of sulfur to be taken depending on the convenience and the amount of medicine you are taking for the preparation. The temperature, it is given mild, medium and high temperatures till it melts the gandak. Once the gandak is melted, try to constant the temperature, usually mandagni. Usually mandagni is being maintained, but the time period, of course, it will take sufficient time. Sometimes it takes around 1.5 to 2 hours, sometimes 3 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, depending on the strength of the medicine. You want to prepare Tridhatu Garbha Pottali, that is Trivangas, then it takes approximately around 8 hours for treating it. So this is how the time varies depending on the prime drug. And the Pakalakshanas, of course, it gives a resonant sound. The kalka which you have prepared is not resonant. When you take a metallic spoon and hit around it, it doesn't give a resonant sound. But in case if you hit it once the Pakalakshan is over, then it's totally resonant. It is just like two metal pieces are hitting each other. So this is one of the Pakalakshan. The another Pakalakshan is the Gandak starts to turn more darker and more viscous. The third Lakshana is the silk cloth will cut open and the pottali will fall into the sulfur bath. Then immediately it should be removed. So either of these lakshanas can be observed while preparing. And the paschat karma, removed from the sulfur bath and it is being polished. You just scrape the outer content of that, might be with a knife or any substance of that kind. Easily it can be scraped out, and after that it is being taken for the rasa pujana. And after the rasa pujana, we speak about few of the alterations. This is what till now the textbook has told. These are the alterations not mentioned in the textbook. These are our adaptations in our practice based on our clinical experiences. So few such clinical experiences here is add any drug like which are having water content in it, H2O. Oxidation is synthesized, increased in the pottali kalpanas. Say for example, you add kasisa. As in small concentrations into any of the pottalis, the absorption level in the body is very high. Oxidative process in the body is very high. Ama nashana shakti or ama kshaya is very quick. So here you can, by doing this, you can have an enhancement of the property. There are primarily 4 drugs which we can add, which is having water as an essential component. One is kasisa, tutta, tankana, spatika. These are the 4 components, either of these can be used, but most commonly kasisa is used to a smaller extent. To increase the potency of it, you can treat the pottali with the small concentrations of abraka sattva or swarnamakshika sattva, which will becomes very, very rasayana in property. It becomes highly rasayana in property, by which the enhancement of the properties has been well appreciated. And for increasing the drug action, of course, gandak is used, shodhita gandaka, because of the polymerization. It builds the valency of sulfur is 8. So it gives a very beautiful chain of molecules with all the ingredients which you have added for the preparation and gives a maximum benefit to the patient. For increasing the tivrata and bubukshata, you are supposed to treat the mercury which you are using in Pottali Kalpanas with any tikshna dravyas. Might be it is something like Haratala and Manashila. Before you process it, try to treat it with Haratala and Manashila, then prepare the Pottali Kalpana, then it becomes more tivra, more quick in action. So any formulation can be taken into Pottali. Say for example, I want to give Kumara Kalyana Rasa to a particular patient, you can prepare Kumara Kalyana Pottali. You want to give Jaimangal to any patient, you can give Jaimangala Pottali. You want to give Vasanta Kusumakara to a patient, you can give it in the form of Vasanta Kusumakara Pottali. So like that, there are so many classical references which are said in the text. Any drug can be altered into Pottali Kalpanas. So you have any of the ingredients which are being explained. Say for example, Vanga is very good in diabetes. So you want to treat your patient, you can do only Vanga Garbha Pottali. You want to use Naga in the patient, do Naga Garbha Pottali. So this alterations can be done, then the number of Pottalis will become innumerable. It becomes innumerable. So on this grounds, let us see, sir, this is not there in the textbook, then how can we analyze it? Whether will it be safe or will it be effective? So on that grounds here, I would like to present this case. So this is a case of a neonate of age 4 days and bilateral intraventricular bleeding in a brain of a neonate, possibly because of a birth injury, possibly because the reason for why it has a bleeding from the brain was not noted. And the age of the child is only 4 days. You can see the reports of this particular patient. You can see the size of the hemorrhage. Its intraventricular bleed is seen on both the frontals. So the child was having a presentation of a paralysis by the time it was being born. And sucking reflex was negative, Mohs sign was negative. None of the milestones which are to be appreciated were not seen in the child. Then later the brain scan showed like intraventricular hemorrhage. And these are the further reports of the same patient. You can see the distress and the size of the hematoma. You can see the size is 9:7 and on the left side it is 8:4. This is the presentation, the size of the hematoma which is present in the brain of a child of age 4. And you can see, we have started with Kumara Kalyana Pottali. So Kumara Kalyana Rasa, where in the Phalashruti he tells about the reflexes are being built up. All the reflexes whichever is not appreciated in the neonate or the child is being appreciated once you start giving Kumara Kalyana Rasa. So on that grounds, Kumara Kalyana Pottali was given to this particular patient. And you can see the response here after 2 days of the treatment with the Kumara Kalyana Pottali, the size of the bleed has come to 9:7 mm. It is reduced in its size. And this is a further evaluation, 9:7 on the left side and on the right side it is 8:4. Another 4 to 5 days, again it has been suggested. You can see the size is again 9:7 and 7:6. So it again, hematoma is again reduced. Again you can see the size here after 5 days. The size of the hematoma is further reduced. You can see 8:5 into 5.7 and 7:4 into 6 mm. This is the impression you can read out. It is smaller and more hypoechoic, more organized since the last scan. So it's very much organized, the hematoma. Or else the only option we have is craniotomy. You have to operate it and try to remove the hematoma from the child's brain. And it is usually considered as high-risk surgeries because the age of the child is only 4 days. And this is the next scan report. You can see it is 8.5 into 5.5, 7.4 into 6. And this is after another 1 week. You can see the size has come to 2.2 and another side is also into 2. So the size is highly minimized. It is highly minimized. Of course, the reflexes start to set in. The child had a Mohs sign, sucking reflex positive, no facial palsy, no paralytic-like presentations were being observed in the child. And these are the further reports. You can see the impression here, 2.2 into 2 cc. And this is further, after another 1 week, you can see 0.5 into 1.8 cc. It is almost negligible. This size is very, very small. And the child survived. That's more important. So this is the praise of the Pottalis. This is the praise of the Pottalis. Whenever you are supposed to give it, you are supposed to offer that amount of prayers because it's going to save your patient's life. And it is an emergency medicine. It is an emergency medicine. So this is the Rasa Pujana which we carry out for all the Pottalis once it has been prepared. This is an example which you see with the Hemagarbha Pottali. Of course, this I use to the maximum extent in all the malignant cases. So it is to be done. There is a research which has been done by Masaru Emoti on the water molecules, which is also considered as a non-living thing. Observe the crystalline structures by doing a pujan and see the changes in the water molecules. You can see it on YouTube. It's very, very much impressive. And you will definitely accept like what the text spoke about the Rasa Pujan is very, very appropriate. The bhavana and anupana can be selected based on the drugs whichever you want to try with that particular therapeutic administration. Scrape the pottali and never hammer it. Never pound it. Don't use kalvayantra. You are supposed to scrape it and give. As I told you, gandak is a prime component which is given. The valency of sulfur is 8. It links up all the molecules whichever you have used and it takes it out when you scrape it. When you hammer it, sulfur is brittle, it breaks up, the chain is broken in between, then the therapeutic efficacy might not be observed in the patient. So instead, if you want the maximum efficacy in the patient, you're supposed to scrape it. And don't believe in any of the conditions wherein the pottali can be scraped that easily. No, it's not an easy task. I will say, I'll give you 1 gram of Rajatagarbha pottali, you will not be able to scrape that 1 gram in 1 hour. It is equivalent to stone. It is so hard. That is a good pakalakshana of pottali kalpas. If you scrape it and it immediately disperses, then no paka. It's not done in a proper paka form. It is to be very hardened. You need efforts to scrape it. I give pravala garbha, I ask the patient to take it around 8 grams per month. The patient says, my hand started paining now. Because to scrape 8 grams in 1 month, my hand is paining and I need treatment for scraping the things. So this is the way how it comes with. It should be hard enough. The pottali should be hard enough. This is what the textbook speaks about, the mode of action of any rasa dravya. Sa rasaha kramate dehe siddhaya sambhavantihi rasayane tu ya prokta mulika dehe siddhidaha. That is the importance of anupanam. Suitable anupana to be selected. Or else it is something like you are sending a person without a driver. It is something like you are sending a person without a driver who takes you in your car to the said place without a proper guide. It's not possible. So on that grounds, you are supposed to give a suitable anupanam for all the pottalis. So this is how it starts to act. This is how it starts to act at the DNA level or the proteins. A test was being carried out considering the time limit. I did not get the video. I have just got the photos of it. Hemagarbha pottali is having an excellent action on the brain tumors, CVA, cerebrovascular accidents, and hematomas of the brain. So on that grounds, a test was being carried out. And it is called as from the Department of Bioinformatics. We can see the data which can be analyzed that the Hemagarbha pottali molecule is directly being fixed into the brain receptor. This is the preparation of a Hemagarbha pottali. And this is a brain receptor protein. We have a video, but I did not get it now. This is the red one. What you are seeing is a brain receptor protein. And the chain of molecules which you are seeing is the Hemagarbha pottali. It has linked very appropriately, and it gives a value at what level it can show action in your patient. So on that grounds, of course, it is very, very effective and gives a very good impression. So this is the importance of Hemagarbha pottali. Of course, extensively useful drug in the clinical practice. So this method is called as a docking. So this docking mechanism will help you to analyze whether this drug will be therapeutically active before you give it to your patient or not. Combination of the pottalis. This is another method wherein we take up. It is called as yugma pottali. Even this terms you will not get it from any of the textbooks. It is based on your experiences, how it can be formulated. Two different types of pottalis or mix it together and advise together or prepare together and give it to your patient gives a tremendous effect. It is called as yugma pottali. It is not from the textbook. Again, I say that. Say, for example, here you have a patient with malignancy. Habragarbha and Hemagarbha pottalis are mixed together and it is given. during the formulation itself. By the time you prepare it, you mix up the contents of Abhragarbha and Hemagarbha together and you give it to the patient, then it is more effective in malignancy patients. In case if you mix up Tamragarbha and Vishagarbha, it is very good as anti-malignant, or the other word I would like to use it is arrest the metastasis. It will arrest the metastasis, the spread of the metastasis, spread of the malignancy in the body. So this is how it acts. This is called as Yugma Pottali. You mix up two different Pottalis and make one new molecule. This is Abhra and Hema. So route of drug administration, this is also very important. The textbook speaks about the dosage. It is to be given around 60 milligrams, 125 milligrams and all. Sushruta is a very practical person. He tells the mode of drug administration in a various ways, especially when he speaks about the Vrana Chikitsa. He tells about the 60 types of drug administrations. It can be given in the form of lepa, it can be given in the form of dhupana, it can be given oral administration. The same technique on the grounds of Sushruta, I tried to adopt it in the Pottalikalpas. And you can see the changes here. It is given the oral route, just like we give any other tablets or anything like that. The second thing is I give it in the form of kavala and gandusha. I give it a Pottali in the form of nasya, as claimed by Baishija Ratnavali for Shwasakutara Rasa. Nasya is to be given as per the text. It is given as a lepana in case of malignant patients. It is applied through endoscope to the affected area. Like you have a patient with an abdominal tumor, CA of the gastrium, CA of duodenum. Through the endoscope, we enter into the patient's body. We take this Pottali scraped and it has been locally applied through the endoscope in the affected area. So this is done with through endoscope. Through the colonoscope it is reaching, especially in the conditions like you have ulcerative colitis, malignancies of the big vessels, the GAT, lower GAT, and in the form of enemas. Also in the form of enemas, we give Pottalis. Say for example, you have Mrityunjaya Rasa, the oral route, whatever is being prescribed, the dosage, the same dosage is applied in any other means. Yama matram hareta jwaram is a word which you get. But when we give Mrityunjaya Rasa for even 3 to 5 days, sometimes you find no changes in the patient. Instead, you take Mrityunjaya Rasa, the same oral dosage, I don't want excess dosage, and give it in the form of enema. It reduces the fever very quickly. Then you find yama matram hareta jwaram. So this is the importance of how the dosage system can be altered. A kavala and gandusha, as I told you, this is a patient of malignancy of a piriform fossa, which was in the observed. The patient had hoarseness of the voice and he started to, the spread of the illness was seen. Kavala and gandusha was given with Tamragarbha Pottali, and of course, once or twice we tried even with a laryngoscope, we tried to enter to the nearest point of the larynx and applied the Tamragarbha. You can see that black color is the malignancy, and over that we have applied the Tamragarbha. And I'll say this patient is surviving even today. You can see the reports, it is from 2015. Today is 2019, the patient is still alive, and the tumor, wherever you find, it has been sloughed off. It has been removed, it is necrotized, and it has been removed off totally. So this is how they act on kavala and gandusha form. You have patients with oral carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma of the oral cavity, or you have any such conditions, including might be something like sore ulcers of the mouth, vitamin B deficiency, in any of these conditions. Pravalagarbha is given and we ask the patient to go for kavala. So this is another report wherein an example for the lepakalpana. So this is a case which was being already diagnosed as a CA of the breast, and she had a huge massive growth after the mastectomy. Huge ulcers were formed and multiple metastases were seen in the thoracic cavity. Of course, the patient ulcerations was so severe, and these are the PET scan report of that particular patient. You can see the reports. It is a duct cell carcinoma lesion recurrence. You can see the recurrence. It's very common in CA breast. And it is a invasive duct carcinoma, grade 3. So as a lepana in malignant ulcers, as I told you, one thing is Mallagarbha and Tamragarbha. Two choices I take. This is a lesion of the patient with a breast carcinoma. And the ulceration was too huge and discharge was very high. On his grounds, we have applied Mallagarbha and Tamragarbha to the patient. You can see the observation of the ulcer later. You can see multiple nodules surrounding, they are the metastatic zones. See, it started to dry up. It is totally drying up, and this is how it presented with. And she's fine. It's totally, almost normal. The pain comes down, and added to that, the condition is much better. Added to that, we have given oral administration as well. It's not like only lepana was used. We have given many oral medicines, as I told you, Hemagarbha, Vishagarbha, and Sarveshwara Parpati were also given to this particular patient, and the response is highly appreciable. This is another case of squamous cell carcinoma. He is a allopathic doctor from US, and he's come for the treatment, and this was application being done with Mallagarbha on the squamous cell. By the time he comes, it was almost 6 to 7 inches wound on his temporal part of the face. By the time he left India, it was hardly less than half inch. And this is the oldest case which I have treated with squamous cell carcinoma. Possibly the patient is from past 8 or 9 years back. If anyone of you attended my previous presentations, there is a list of this patient's reports being presented. You can see them. Today, because of time, I bought only one pic. You can see how it has been necrotized. It gets necrotized. As a basti dravya and ulcerative proctitis, this is a small girl of 9 years. You can see it is a diagnosed case of ulcerative proctitis, and within one shot of enema with a pravala garbha pottali, you can see the reports of a colonoscope as a normal study, possibly within a short period of 30 days. The whole of the condition has been totally regressed. So anyway, people are worried in case if something has happened higher to the zone where the colonoscope is not reached. So we have done abnormal radiograph as such, it is normal. So the girl is fine. So this is Tamragarbha, which is also used for the Kshara Sutras for applying in fistula in ANO. And of course, the efficacy of it is very, very good, and the healing is very faster. So treatment planned up primarily for the general disorders, it's at the 4 zones. One thing to maintain the swasthyata. So wherever you want to maintain the swasthyata, Acharya from Anandaganda speaks of nityam swarnam and nityam paradam. 2 substances which you are supposed to take in constant for every day. So on that grounds, so nitya rasayana, rasagarbha pottali to be given. Of course, dinacharya and rutucharya are to be followed. You take nitya rasayana in the form of rasagarbha, then it is going to protect you and ward you from the diseases. Shroto dushti chikitsa, in case if you want to avoid the shroto dushti, the textbook speaks about the shrota, shrota mula, shrota dushti, and shrota vidha lakshanas. So how the treatment should be planned up in either of these conditions? One thing is swasthasya swastha rakshanam. Of course, you have done it already now. The next part is in case if shroto dushti, you find some signs and symptoms of shroto dushti which are being explained in the text. So wherever you find a drug which is appropriate in that particular condition, say for example, I have a case of some respiratory illness, might be it is some bronchitis or something, I would like to prefer some pottali like Mallagarbha. I will say Mallagarbha pottali in all the respiratory illness is a something like hitting the bullseye. It works far better than a steroid. It works far better than a steroid. Especially you have small kids who are frequently affected, especially in these climates. It is called as hyperactive airway disease. Frequently they land up into cold, cough, fever and all. I will say give only single drug Mallagarbha pottali with somasav as an anupanam. It's a trigger shot and the child will never have any of these conditions in future. So that is how it starts to act. Similarly, you can see with this particular condition, my choice will be Mallagarbha for the patient as to treat the shroto dushti chikitsa, whichever is seen. In case the shroto moola chikitsa, every shrotas is given a particular moola. And unfortunately, many of us don't take this into consideration. Say, for example, a patient is suffering from shwasa since a long time. You try to protect his heart as well. Rasava shrotasam moolam hrudaya dasha damanyaha. So on that grounds, protect the moola. In case if moola is going to affect, again it's going to spread to the further dhatus and it is going deeper and deeper. So on that grounds, what I do, I select the drugs which is good for hrudaya, which is good for shwasa. So on that grounds, whenever you want shroto moola chikitsa or chronicity of the illnesses where you find, in all such conditions what we do is, The same example of Shwasa, Abraka is a drug of choice. Abraka is a Shwasa Kasahara and also it is Rudhya. It is having Rudhya property, also it is Kasa Shwasahara. So my choice of drug in chronicity of the respiratory illness is Abragarbha Pottali. I don't give Mallagarbha there. For instant effect, I give Malla, but I switch on to Abragarbha later. So this is how you can change your treatment protocols once you have varied clinical conditions. Similarly, Shroto Vidha Chikitsa, emergency managements. Most of the times you find them, either it is the Vidha because of the vitiated doshas or because of some external injuries, etc. Whatever might be. In all such emergency conditions, as I told you, Hemagarbha is a drug of choice. One thing I'll say, when you read the Phalashruti of Hemagarbha, he speaks about the word called as Ojokshaya. Wherever you have Ojokshaya, in all such conditions you are supposed to give Hemagarbha. And in all these conditions you find Ojakshaya, you find the deterioration of the dhatus in the body. So in all such conditions, Hemagarbha will protect the patient. The another preparation which has been told in the text is a Ratnagarbha. Ratnagarbha is another one where he speaks about in the Phalashruti, where no medicines you know is acting on the patient, try to administer Ratnagarbha, it is for sure going to act in your patient. So on that grounds, in Shroto Vidha, any of the conditions, you can use either of these things as an emergency management. So based on this, you find the shrotasas and their potalis, which are very specific to act on the particular shrotas. In case if it is rasa and raktava shrotas, lohagarbha and pravalagarbha are to be given. In case if it is mamsavaha shrotas, tamra, visha and rajatagarbha. If it is medhava shrotas, talagarbha and shilagarbha. Asthivaha shrotas, pravalagarbha and tamragarbha. Majjavaha Shrotas, Mallagarbha and Rajatagarbha. Shukravaha Shrotas, Tridhatugarbha. In case if it is Ojas, Hemagarbha and Ratnagarbha. So this will become a protocol for us to treat the patient in case if you can identify a particular Shrotas is being involved in the patient. So we'll try to go up. I don't want to go with what are Shrota, Shrotamula, Lakshanas and all. Considering like everyone know about the Lakshanas, we'll try to go up with the cases. Alone. You have a patient with pranava shrotas, the choices of drugs which you might have is the pravalagarbha, mallagarbha, talagarbha, shilagarbha, hemagarbha, etc. Either of these things can be given to the patient. And shilagarbha is more potent and quick in action. It is very quick in action, especially if you have a patient with respiratory illness alone. And we would like to go up with this particular case. The patient had a sudden breathlessness wherein he was being taken for an investigation. It was found like a pericardial effusion was being observed in the patient. Tapping was done and after that it was confirmed like it is because of the malignancy. PET scan was done to the patient. You can see the reports of the PET scan of the patient. Numerous tumors all over the chest and the thoracic cavity is being observed. You can see the sizes of the tumors. It is 11.5, 10.4 into 10.9 centimeter, not millimeter. So there are considerably very huge sized malignant tumors of the thoracic cavity. It is being seen due to this, the patient had sudden breathlessness. So in this particular patient, Hemagarbha, Vishagarbha, Lohagarbha, along with that, Sarveshwara Parpati was being given. You can see the reports of this particular patient after 6 months. Anterior and middle mediastinal mass germ cell tumor. This is a thoracic PET scan, CT scan. You can see all the tumors have disappeared. All the tumors are disappeared. Only one small size, 2 millimeter sized carcinoma is being observed in the mediastinum. Very small size. All the other malignancies or the metastasis has been totally disappeared. The patient is physically fine. Of course, malignancy still positive, but physically is totally fine and back to his work and his routine in his duties. So this is the zoom up of the same report. So this is another case of the giant cell tumor. By the time this patient has come to me, he had a metastasis of nearly 16 to 18 places all over his thoracic cavity and the body. This is his reports. A highly big sized signet cell carcinoma you can see here with huge metastasis and the sizes are being mentioned. Nearly 16 to 18 places all over the thoracic cavity and he was being treated almost from past 3 or 4 years, or even 6 years, I expect. So this particular patient was given with, he's still on the treatment. He'll be coming for the treatment for Panchakarma as well, because I use Pottali into Panchakarma as well, as I told you. He's got his appointment by next week. And I'll be going again for further investigations. All his tumors have been totally disappeared. You can see the PET scan report of this particular patient for every 6 months. You can see, I just scroll down. You can see the sizes of the tumors, and everything is totally been disappeared. It's a normal chest X-ray. Even in many of the patients, it happens like consolidation of the tumors will be seen. Calcification of the zone of affected area in the lungs can be observed. Even his X-ray is normal. Forget about the PET scan and other investigations. They are, however, normal. Added to that, even X-ray, there is no even consolidation of the lungs or the lesions. He has one giant cell tumor in the elbow that alone is present to a very, very smaller extent. Other than that, the whole of the reports are totally normal. These are the reports. Next is a Udakava Shrotas, possibly the least observed Shrotas in the clinical practice, but very important because this has its action on every Shrotas on the body. Anywhere you have Shrota, the inflammation or any of the pathologies, this is going to act. Say for example, on this particular zone, one drug which acts tremendously is Rajatagarbha, second thing is Lohagarbha. These two drugs are to act wonderfully in any of the Udakava Shrota Vyadis. Next is Rajatagarbha. Annava Shrotas, these are very common nowadays because of the lifestyle disorders. The drugs are Tamragarbha, Pravalagarbha, Ananda Bhairava Pottali, Pravala Panchamruta Parpati, and Rasagarbha. So these are the specific to the Rasa and Raktava Shrotas, because most of them occur together. Formulation used in Rudroga, Prabhakaravati, it even in the form of Pottali, Nagarjuna Bharas in form of Pottali. This is a case report of a patient. You can see the ejection factor is 30% in 2D echo. Here, this size. It is 30%. He was a bedridden patient, and after 45 days of treatment, you can see the ejection factor has come to 58%. So here for this particular patient, we have given Prabhakaravati, one thing in the form of Pottali, added with that Hemagarbha was given to the patient. You can see the ejection factor report before and after treatment. This is another case report of a patient wherein he had a severe exertional dyspnea and changes in the ECG was being observed. To zoom up, you can see it is a inferior infarct. It is a inferior infarct of the patient. And these are the 2D echo report. You can see the conclusion there. And this was almost emergency management wherein Hemagarbha was given to that particular patient. And you can see the report possibly in another 2 to 3 hours. So this is the report of that particular patient. So myoglobulin, CKMB, and troponin 1. The test was carried out after 2 hours, confirming like the patient is out of MI. Confirming like the patient is out of MI, because ECG changes will take some time, and of course, the blood test is also very interactive in case of diagnosing any of such cases, and the reports has come down to normal. So the patient is out of MI, he is not into MI. So this is another report wherein you have erythrocytopenia, and the platelets idiopathic, the platelet was not more than 40,000 in the lifetime. And by giving Pravalagarbha, it has come to 1.2 lakh in 3 months of time. Pravalagarbha along with Lohagarbha was given to this particular patient, and the reports were seen to 1.2 lakh for the first time in the life of this particular patient. And it maintained, the age of the patient is 59 years. So there is a term called as a Sankochakaranadinam Balakrut, Tutta Kasisas Patikan Mrudhara Shringa can be used wherever you find there is a Shrotho Sankocha. So Raktava Shrotas, this is a case report of myeloid leukemia, acute myeloid leukemia, and you can see the blast cells coming from 98% to zero. Of course, he had a metastasis and the patient expired later, but acute myeloid leukemia was being answered. Avoid the metastasis, as I told you. This is one such example of a PET scan of a report with huge amount of metastasis. To arrest the metastasis, Vishagarbha alone is sufficient. Vishagarbha Pottali is given along with Varunadikvata as Anupanam. You can find the report of this particular PET scan report later. This one. All have become very small, and she is around 74 or 75 years. She survived at least for 6 years and still alive. And she is doing her own activities. It's not like she's bedridden. And she's not on rails tube feeding at all. She's on normal feed. This is a liver parenchymal disease, cirrhosis of the liver, which was admitted in an ICU. You can see the report of this particular patient. It's become, the cirrhosis has been reversed by giving Tamragarbha along with Kumaryasava as an Anupanam. Along with that, we have given Arogyavardhini and a Krithpli Hariloha. This is another case of hepatitis virus, hepatitis B. These are the positive reports which were seen in 98. These are the reports which is seen in 2018. And HBsAg negative is being observed in the patient. Of course, I don't claim this for every patient, it happens. The only drug given to this patient also was only Tamragarbha along with that Kumaryasava. Kushtagna, the drugs which can be used are Pravalagarbha, Lohagarbha, Talakeshwara, Talagarbha and Sarveshwara Parpati. Observe the changes in the patient by administering either of these drugs in chronicity of the illnesses, especially with such clinical conditions. Talagarbha is a very promising drug. It's a promising drug in all such conditions, which are to be used, provided one thing, pitta is not at highly involved zone. In case if pitta is involved, try up only with pravala and loha. Don't give arsenic preparations. In case if his pitta is manageable condition, then you can go with talagarbha to all such patients. This is a keratinization of the palmar plantar psoriasis, and for this particular patient we have given with Lohagarbha. You can see the changes of the patient. Possibly we have taken around 6 to 8 months for treating the patient. You have a relapsation in most of the conditions. Treat the autoimmune system, then the patient will be fine. Don't treat alone Kushta. Normally what happens, Kushtagna dravyas are added. Give some autoimmune medicines which can boost up their immunity. The body knows how to act by itself. Then it will take up the whole condition. This is Sarveshwara Parpati. This is Pemphigus vulgaris. She had a chipping out of the skin all over the body. Very, very pathetic to see the patient. Very, very pathetic to see the patient. Now she is having only one lesion. You can see very small lesion there. That's all. She was being treated with the same combination of Hemagarbha. As I told you, it's autoimmune disorder. Answer the immune system. Don't alone think about the Kushtagna factor. You should plan up for the action which is seen at an autoimmune system. And this is an abdominal tumor. Can you place the video, please? So through the endoscope, we go up to the lesion and we try to apply the preparations to the affected area. We have most of them like abdominal cancers, CA, stomach, esophagus. Play the video. Yeah. This is through the endoscope. We are going inside. And you can see the tumors there. And the medicine, whatever you find, it is appropriate for that particular patient. Here, this is CA stomach. So we have taken Hemagarbha. It is mixed along with I'll show you another one. That is Anupanam. It's a product of ant, and that is being taken and it is being sprayed in the local area through the endoscope, and you can see how the tumor will start to bleed and it shrinks away. Many times you have dysphagia because of the size of the tumor, and by applying these things, what happens? The tumors will shrink and the patient's life expectancy is being increased. You can see the medicine is being sprayed there. This is a tumor. You can see on the superior side, you can see the size of the tumor and the medicine is being sprayed. And it starts to bleed, and once it starts to bleed, it starts to shrink away. And once it shrinks away, then the tumor will be, see, it is so huge, it is literally obstructing that area. Sometimes it happens like we try to touch it and see that the fresh bleed is being absorbed so that the medicine can be absorbed locally. The medicine can be absorbed locally. And we spray the medicine. You can see it start to bleed now. And it will start to shrink. Just like you treat with arshas, with any of the kshara karma, you apply locally kshara for the arshas, how does it shrink? In the same way, it was being thought of to apply it for the tumors. You can see. So you can come back to the PowerPoint. So like that, we go for even colonoscope, we go for endoscope, we go for laryngoscope, and try to see where all it is reachable, and try to apply it to the patient to have a local action. Say for example, I give 125 milligram, it goes and assimilates in the whole body. I give the same dosage of 125 milligram only on the tumor, then the concentration is more on the tumor. So this is a only phenomena, there is nothing else which has been done there. So this is another one, these are the red ants which are very commonly seen in the Western Ghats, and they build up their houses, and these are the eggs. And the folklore people use the juice of this egg in the form of anti-tumorous medicine. So the Pottali either can be taken, it has been scraped in either of the juices of these eggs, and it has been used as an anti-cancerous. Or if you don't have this available, even Bhandira, there is a plant which is commonly available throughout India, Bhandira. Bhandira rasa also can be taken for the application. So this is another one where we have tried. Pitta factor was very high here. Burning sensation was very high. So here for the tumor in the endoscope, we applied it with Panchavalkala Kvata as an anupanam. So this is such an example wherein we have treated the patient. It was a necrotizing tumor. Wherever the tumors were spreading, it was necrotized, and it is totally turned normal after 45 days of treatment. It is considerably shrunken, and the tumors are totally necrotizing is arrested. So this is pemphigus vulgaris of the patient, which was being under treatment now with Pravala and Hemagarbha. This is a goiter. You can see the size of the nodules. It has been significantly reduced with administration of Tamragarbha. Isthmus is totally turned to normal. The goiter is reduced, well addressed with the medicines. You can see the sizes of the nodules of the goiter is being significantly reduced. This is another case wherein it was been observed a nodule on both of the tumors on the either sides of the thyroid. You can see it is malignancy positive, FNAC positive, and Tamragarbha along with Hemagarbha was given in the patient. You can see the reports of this particular patient later, and here you can see on the left hand side it is given FNAC is totally normal. You can see the last line, no evidence of any malignancy seen in the smears. So it is totally out of malignancy for that particular patient. So people are worried giving rasaushadhi's kidneys get destroyed. Ultimately, see the creatinine value of the patient. Because people are unwantedly scared about giving rasaushadhi's. I don't know why, because in my clinic I got 85 to 90% of rasaushadhi's. 10 to 15% of course, I definitely honor and I use herbal drugs as well. But I did not find any creatinine values being two peaks because of administration of rasaushadhi's. Diabetes is one such case of this group of drug. Chandraparbha, Arogyavardhani, Tridhatu Garbha, Rasagarbha, Hemagarbha, Talagarbha and Shilagarbha. In case if it is Kati, these are the reports wherein Chandraparbha in the form of Pottali was given to the patient. Vasanta Kusumakara was given. You can see the reports before and after. Astiva Shrotas, Pravala and Tamra. Osteoblastoma, this is a case of malignancy. Here osteoblastoma, you can see the size of the tumor. Tridhatu Garbha, Pravala and Loha was given to the patient. He was being operated for nearly 6 to 7 times to repair it, but it was not possible. See, these are the X-ray reports. You can see so many rods being implanted. And he has been well addressed with the medicine. You can see the granulation tissue, and it is totally been healed up. This is Majjhava Shrotas, psoriatic arthritis. These are the various conditions wherein we change up the Pottalis. In case if it is Amavastha, Mallagarbha Pottali and Vishagarbha, Pakvavastha, Samira Pannaga Yogaraja, Tamragarbha is given. In case if it's Jirnavastha, Hemagarbha and Abragarbha are given. Abragarbha is a drug of choice in all osteoarthritic like conditions. In case if it is gouty arthritis, Vishagarbha is a drug of choice. Shukrava Shrotas, these are the drugs which can be given, Hema, Tridhatu, Purna Chandrodaya. Trifala with Makaradvaja, Mallagarbha, Pravalagarbha are the drug of choices. This is a patient of ulcerative colitis where we have given Pravalagarbha and Lohagarbha in the form of enema. You can see the colonoscope report of this particular patient prior to the treatment of Rasaushadis. This is how it started to heal, and almost within 3 months, you can see the changes in the GIT with the colonoscope. It's almost normal. So Pravalagarbha was given to this particular patient in the form of enema. So Jwara, here Swedoha Shrotas, Jayamangalras in the form of Pottali is being given. Of course, if it has not been answered well, then Sarva Vishama Jwarantaka Loha is given in the form of Pottali or individually. Pravalagarbha and Mallagarbha. Rajatagarbha is a drug of choice in female infertility. Hemagarbha is a drug of choice in male infertility. These are the other set of drugs which are to be used. In case if it is a multiple organ failure, many times you find these patients with multiple organ failure like this. You can see this is a report of a patient with multiple organ failure. Ratnagarbha is given in such conditions. Ratnagarbha is given. You can see all systems are being involved. This is importance of Hemagarbha and Ratnagarbha. These are the drugs which you can select in case if it is Asadhya Roga Nashtakara, Dhatu Vivardhana, Ojo Vardhaka, Mrutyugna, Pushtivardhana, Pushtikara, Sarva Vyadihara, Papagna and Sarvaguna, Sadguna Vardhana. All these are the set of drugs which can be formulated in the form of Pottali. So this is about the Pottali practice which is given. In every srotas, wherever it has been involved, we try to inoculate the Pottali kalpas. And this is what the importance of Pottalis are being observed. My clinic, possibly many would have seen it even, there's a mural art of Ayurveda Avatarana, Brahma Sprutva Aishovedam Tam Prajapati Majagrata, the same thing in the form of murals. The last set from the Avatarana is the Dhanvantri, wherein he keeps with Amruta Kalasha in one hand, and I have made it in the form of a mural art, in other hand he keeps Pottalis. So Dhanvantri is having Pottali in one hand and Amruta Kalasha in one hand, and to the level of this extent, we use Pottalis in the clinical practice. Thank you.